Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Good day, Angie Thomas.
Hi, how are you?
I am exceptionally well, and welcome to the Valder Beebe Show. I'm broadcasting live out of Dallas, Texas, and my audience is so excited to hear about you and your new book, On the Come Up. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
But before we get to the On the Come Up, we got to talk about your phenomenal success on The Hate That You Give. That's a movie and a book. How exciting is that for you in your career at this time?
You know, it's phenomenal. I wake up every single day like, am I living a dream? Because this was my dream as a kid growing up. And to actually see this happening, I can't believe it. You know, it's an honor, too, to know that so many people connected with The Hate You Give and recommended it to their friends and family. So I'm extremely humbled by that. You know, there are so many books out there and it could have happened to anyone. So I'm so thankful that it happened to me.
You got to just share with me. I'm a big visionary, and I'm teaching a class on vision, and you said you dreamed about this when you were a kid. Did you see it in your head? Did you think about it all the time? Give us a little bit of that dream.
Yeah, you know, for me, when I was a kid, I would write stories, and I always dreamed of seeing them come to life on television or on movies. So that was always the thing that I would tell my mom. I would say, you know, well, if I write, I'm going to write this story, and I want this person to play this part and this person to play that part. And I was calling off all of these Hollywood actors and actresses as if I was casting them in my movie, you know, and casting them in my books. So it was there from an early age, you know, and my mom is a firm believer that if you see something, it can come to life. And so she told me, well, baby, if that's what you want to do, if that's what you can see happening in your life, then go for it. So I have to say she's the reason that I'm here and doing this now, because she encouraged me then to continue to not only see it, but to pursue it.
You got a smart mom.
Yeah.
Tell me about, I got to ask you also, too, about hip-hop. What does hip-hop mean to you, and how does it impact your life? Because a lot of time, hip-hop is not embraced by the larger society.
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, and when it's done well, for me, it speaks to me, and for so many young people in this country, it's our voice, and it's our mirror, you know. I remember the first time I heard Keep Your Head Up by Tupac, and he said, I give a holler to my sister is on welfare, Tupac cares if don't nobody else care. He was speaking to me and so many other kids like me, and that was the first time I felt seen. So what hip-hop does is it makes us visible. It gives us a voice and it empowers us. And for so many young people, when it keeps it real with them, that's what they want. And that's, I often say, I want to write the way that rappers rap. I want a kid to pick up an Angie Thomas book and feel that same connection as if they were listening to a hip-hop song, someone who's being real and authentic with them and who speaks for them and to them. So for me, it was the mirror I needed and the voice that I needed.
You are fueling, to me, the renaissance in the publishing world. What I mean is, you know, where Terry McMillan and Carl Weber and Maya Angelou kind of left off, you are now bringing dollars to the table. You are showing publishers that you can create an audience the way you look, the way you write, the words that you say. How important is that on the move come up? How important was it getting that book deal for them to know that?
It was really important for me. You know, I'm very blessed in the sense that my publisher, Balzer and Bray Harper Collins, they've been so supportive, and they're all about me being my authentic self and telling stories that are authentic to me and that I stand behind and that I put my heart into. So they never make me feel as if I have to water anything down or make it so that other people will accept it. You know, it's all about me doing the stories from my heart. So I'm very appreciative of that. It means a lot to know that, too. And it means a lot knowing that hopefully, you know, other publishers are taking note, and that we can see more stories from authors of color featuring characters of color, you know, specifically in children's literature. I'm a real big proponent of that, because kids need books to see themselves, and then other kids need those books to see those kids as well. You know, I think if some of our current political leaders read books about Black kids when they were kids, we wouldn't have to say Black Lives Matter. It would be understood because they'd have that empathy. So I'm a firm believer that the books I write now are investments in the future, and I'm thankful that I get to tell the stories from my heart.
And the title is On the Come Up. Tell me, what's the best part about writing On the Come Up?
You know, for me, the best part about writing On the Come Up was getting to know this character of Brianna and creating a mirror for so many girls who feel the same way that she does, you know, who often feel as if they're either too much or not enough, and her journey of coming to understand that she's perfect just the way she is. You know, Black girls especially, when they enter spaces, they're made to feel as if they're too much or not enough. They're too ghetto, too loud, too aggressive, too this, too that, or they're not intelligent enough. They're not beautiful enough. They're not smart enough, when the fact is they're perfect just the way that they are. So I hope that, you know, by reading this book, they walk away understanding that. And that was one of the best parts for me as an author, was seeing this young woman blossom and become who she is.
Angie, you're going to be in Frisco, Texas, I heard. Tell me so I can sit front and center.
Yes, yes. I'll be at Independence High School on Valentine's Day, actually. And the event starts at 6:30 p.m. I will be in conversation with Dr. Rose Brock. She is a phenomenal academic there, based there in Dallas. And we're going to have an awesome conversation. Trust me, it's not going to be boring. We're going to have fun. And just come out and get to talk about the book and about literature and all of that. And I will be doing a signing as well. So I'm really excited about it. I love visiting the Dallas-Fort Worth area.
Angie Thomas, you are phenomenal yourself. Maya Angelou would be very proud, and we at the Valder Beebe Show, we've got a new friend to be very proud of. Thanks for being my guest today, and I'll look for you in Frisco.
Thank you so much.